Analytics is an important part of a website. Analytics can help you evaluate the performance of your website and can help you optimize your content so you can provide the most value to your users. In a previous video, I covered how to add a Google Universal Analytics property to your Gatsby site. Since that video, Google has released a new version of Google Analytics, and so in this video, I want to show you how to add their new version, Google Analytics 4, to a Gatsby site using a global site tag. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks with Guiding Digital. I'm going to be bringing you videos on this channel about website best practices. So if you're a developer, a marketer, or small business owner wanting to refine your skills and get your content noticed, this channel is for you. And so subscribe below to stay informed about future content. Today, we're going to walk through adding Google Analytics to a Gatsby site. In this video, I use a new version of Google Analytics, Google Analytics 4. If you need an overview of Google Analytics 4, make sure and watch my previous video where I give you 7 things you need to know about Google Analytics 4. Also, this video assumes that you're adding Google Analytics for the first time to your site. If you already have the previous version of Google Analytics on your site, Universal Analytics, I will be publishing a future video on how to upgrade your site to Google Analytics 4. When that is available, I'll put a link here and put the link in the video description. You may still find this video useful for upgrading, but if my video on upgrading is available, I would recommend switching to that video. There are 2 primary ways of adding a new Google Analytics 4 property to your Gatsby site. You can use a global site tag, or you can use Google Tag Manager. So which method should you use? If you have a basic site and all you want is Google Analytics on your site, then using a global site tag, in my opinion, is the simplest method to use. However, if your site is more complex, in addition to Google Analytics, you need to install other marketing tags and other custom Google Analytics events, then I would recommend using Google Tag Manager. In this video, I'm going to cover how to install Google Analytics using a global site tag. In my next video, I'll cover how to add Google Analytics 4 to a Gatsby site using Google Tag Manager. And so I'd recommend switching to that video if it's available if you plan on using Google Tag Manager. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is to create the Google Analytics 4 property. To do that, we'll go to analytics.google.com and we'll be presenting with 1 of 2 different pages. If you've never created a Google Analytics account, you'll see this welcome page. To get started, click the Start Measuring button to go to the Account Setup Wizard. If you already have an account for another website, it will take you to the Home Dashboard for your existing property. To add a new account, click on the Admin link at the bottom of the left navigation, and then from there you can add a new property to your existing account or create a new account. For this video, I'm going to create a new account so we can see the entire process, and so I'll click the Create Account button. On the first screen, enter the account name and then your data sharing settings. I'm going to be stingy and not send Google any additional information by unchecking all of the boxes. And then I'll click the Next button. I'll enter a property name and select my time zone. If you click on the Show Advanced Options button, it gives you an option to create a Universal Analytics property. Universal Analytics is the previous version of Google Analytics. Their new version, Google Analytics 4, has been the default version now for several months. But if for some reason you still need to create a property using the previous version, you can do so by clicking this toggle. You then have a choice of creating both a Google Analytics 4 and a Universal Analytics property, or only a Universal Analytics property. For most cases, in my opinion, there's no need to use this option and create a Universal Analytics property. If you're adding Google Analytics to your website for the first time, then go ahead and use the new version. The only exception is that some third-party services that integrate to websites may not support Google Analytics 4 yet. If this does apply to you, I would recommend keeping the default option of creating both property types so you can at the very least be building up your history in the new version. For this demo, we're just going to create a Google Analytics 4 property, and so we'll toggle this option off and click the Next button. On the next screen, we'll choose our industry category, business size, and indicate our purpose for using Google Analytics. All the options on this screen are optional. We'll then click the Create button to create our property, and then read through the terms if you'd like. Click the checkbox and click the I accept button. Next, we need to add 1 or more data streams to our property. One new feature in Google Analytics 4 is that you can collect data from apps and your website in the same property to get a unified view. For today, we are just focused on our Gatsby website, and so we'll choose the web option and then enter our website URL and give our stream a name. Another nice feature of Google Analytics 4 is that if you use the enhanced measurement feature that is displayed here, then the Google Analytics script will automatically collect additional measurements such as scrolls, outbound links, and file downloads. In the previous version, you had to implement custom solutions to track these events. If for some reason you don't want to track any of these additional items, you can go to the settings and turn them off. There is also a setting we need to adjust here for the page view items to avoid duplicate page views being sent. Gatsby sites under the cover are really single page applications, meaning that as you navigate through a website, the entire payload for the page is not being sent to the browser for each request. Under the covers, Gatsby is updating the page to simulate a new page. For the end user, the website behaves just like any other website, but the fact that the page is not reloaded each time causes issues for solutions like Google Analytics. In previous versions of Google Analytics, the script that Google Analytics gives you to add to your site assumes that the script will be executed each time a user navigates to a new page on your site. And so since this isn't the case for single page applications, you have to add additional code that will manually send a page view event to Google Analytics each time a user navigates to a new page. The plugin we'll be adding to our Gatsby site later in the video takes care of this additional work for you. However, in Google Analytics 4, if you choose to enable enhanced measurements, Google has added a new feature that will send page view events on browser history events. Browser history events are fired in Gatsby whenever a user navigates to a new page. If we leave this setting as is, this will result in duplicate page views being sent each time a user navigates to a new page. To correct this, we need to go into the advanced setting for page views and uncheck the checkbox for page changes based on browser history events. For our demo, we'll leave all the rest of the enhanced measurement items enabled and click the Save button. We'll then hit the Create Stream button to create our stream. Our Google Analytics property is now set up. For now, I'll leave this window open. We'll need to come back to this screen later to copy the measurement ID that is assigned to us. Now we need to configure our Gatsby site to add our new Google Analytics property. As a starting point, I've created an out-of-the-box Gatsby site that was created using the Gatsby new command. The first thing we need to do is to add a plugin to our Gatsby site that will implement the global site tag. And so I'll open up a terminal window within Visual Studio Code. Gatsby has an official plugin for global site tags, and so we'll use that plugin. I'll go to the plugin documentation page for the implementation details. To get to the page, I'll go to the GatsbyJS.com site and go to the plugins section and then search for GTag. The first plugin in the list should be the Gatsby plugin Google GTag. And so click on that item to open up the details page. Then scroll down to the install section and either copy the entire command if you're using NPM as your dependency manager, or copy the plugin name if you're using Yarn. I'm using Yarn as my dependency manager, and so I'll just copy the name. I'll then switch back to Visual Studio Code, and in the terminal window, type yarn add, and then paste in the plugin name and press enter to add the plugin. Next, we need to add the plugin to the Gatsby config files plugins array. I'll go back to the plugins documentation page and go to the how to use section and copy everything between the opening and closing curly braces as a starting point. I'll then switch back to Visual Studio Code. I already have my Gatsby config file open, and so I'll paste in the config at the top of the plugins array. Now let's go through the config options that are included. The first option is the tracking IDs. You'll notice that you can add more than one, and so you can include IDs for Google Analytics and IDs from other tools like Google Ads. In this video, we're just going to be implementing Google Analytics, and so we'll delete these other two. We'll then switch back to the browser and copy our measurement ID, and then switch back to Visual Studio Code and paste the ID in the tracking ID section. In the next section, you can enter the container ID for Google Optimize if you're using that solution. It also gives you settings related to the cookie expiration and a setting that will anonymize your IP address. In some countries, the setting is required to comply with privacy laws. For this demo, I'm going to delete this section. If you're in a country where you need to enable the anonymize IP option, one thing to note is that according to Google's documentation, the debug view that I'll be showing you later in the video does not work when using some of the privacy options. And so you might want to delete these settings as well for now if you want to follow along and use the debug view. You can add them back later when you get ready to launch your site. The next section is the plugin config. Google's recommendation is to place the script in the head of the HTML document, and so I like to change the head setting to true to put the script in the head section instead of the body. For this demo, I'm also going to remove the respect do not track option and the exclude settings for now. Our site is now configured and ready to test. First, let's save our changes, and then we need to open up our site in production mode. The plugin that we are using only sends events for production builds. To do that, we'll run a Gatsby build command to build our site for a production build. and then run a Gatsby serve command to view our site. We can hold down the control key and click the link in the terminal to open the site. I'm going to open the site side by side with the Google Analytics site and give as much room as possible to the Google Analytics window. To verify that our site is sending data, we can go to several places in Google Analytics. If we go to the home dashboard, the only real-time data we see is the number of users in the last 30 minutes. We do see that there was one user, and so that's a good sign. The rest of the data on this page is delayed by about a day. You can also go to the real-time page. This page gives us a more detailed view, and the data is only delayed by about 10 or 20 seconds. And so if we click around on the site, we'll eventually see the data start to flow in. Another way, and in my opinion the best way, when your goal is to verify a new implementation is the debug view page. One requirement to use this view is you'll need to install a Chrome browser extension. And so I'll go to Chrome's extensions by going to More Tools menu item, and then Extensions, and then click on the hamburger menu in the upper left, and click on Open Chrome Web Store to find our extension. Then I'll search for Google Analytics, and we want to install the Google Analytics Debugger extension that is published by Google Analytics. To install the extension, click on the item and click on the Add to Chrome button and then the Add Extension link. Next, we need to enable the extension. To do this, go to the tab you have your Gatsby site open and go to the extensions icon and click on the Google Analytics Debugger item to turn it on for the site. You'll see this debugger connecting or no debugger found message in the lower right. Ignore this. The only thing left to do for the debugger to start working is to refresh the debug view page. Once you refresh the page, you'll notice that it now shows one connected device. You can then click around on your site, and you'll eventually see the events starting coming in after a few seconds. You can click on the event to see the details and examine the individual properties of the event. The last thing I'll show you is how Google Analytics now tracks additional events. As I mentioned earlier, one of the new features of Google Analytics 4 is that it tracks events such as outbound links clicks without any additional coding as long as you have the enhanced measurements enabled. We left those enabled, and so we can click on a link such as this link to the GatsbyJS.com site, and then after a few seconds, we'll see the click event. We can examine the event, and we see that it is the event from the GatsbyJS.com link as we expected. In today's video, we've added Google Analytics 4 to our Gatsby site using the GTAG plugin. In future videos, I'll show you how to add Google Analytics 4 to a Gatsby site using Google Tag Manager and how to upgrade a Gatsby site that currently uses Universal Analytics to Google Analytics 4. Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like and make sure and subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, feel free to leave me a comment or question below and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.